Hi there, I'm Dave Van Ness, and today we're going to take you on a tour of Old Colorado City and show you why you should come and visit.
Welcome to Old Colorado City, where history comes to life.
This Welcome Center was originally built in 1898. It was a butcher shop. The actual butcher shop was in this room, and the family lived in the rest of the house. All the woodwork is original. The floors, we took up the old carpet that was on them, and underneath are the original 1898 hardwood floors, so we refinished them in order to maintain the character of the building. This is a great place to start your visit to the historic district, Old Colorado City, but let me show you a little more of the house. We suppose that the butcher probably stored his meat and aged it down here in the cellar. You can see the old stone foundation. You can see today this provides us storage for all our Christmas decorations and things we use for our events. We put on a lot of events here. This is my office here. Used to be the bedrooms for the family that had the butcher shop downstairs. Out the window, we've got a great view of Pike's Peak on a nice, clear, sunny day. You know, it wasn't a fancy home, but yet look at the interesting work on the hardware here, and the doorknob and the plate. These things are all through the house, whether it's the hinges or the doorknobs or whatever, the mail chute in the front door. It's really sort of fun. One of the promotional items along with our campaign is if you stop in the Welcome Center on your way to Old Colorado City, we'll give you a free shopping bag. We're at 2324 West Colorado Avenue, or you can find us at visitoldcoloradocity.org. Let's stop over here now at the old cabin that was the first territorial capital of Colorado in 1859. Hello, Mr. Mayor.
Ah, good day to you, sir. Delighted you could come by.
What a fine day.
It is a beautiful day, and welcome to the seat of the territorial government.
Absolutely.
This was originally San Juan's Laundry down on 28th and Cacheras, but it was the only structure big enough to hold the territorial convention.
Must not have been many people, huh?
There were not many people in 1861 when they started convening. But it was large enough to hold a contingent from Denver, from Pueblo, and Colorado City, which by that time had taken over the population of the Front Range. And this was the place where we originated the documents for the territory. And we were taken away from the Kansas territory when Kansas was made a state. And they determined that first the name was supposed to be Auraria, but we decided, or Corona was the other word for it, but it was decided Colorado because of the red structure of the rocks in Garden of the Gods, that Colorado would be a far better territorial name, was decided within these hand-hewn walls of Sam Waugh's laundry.
Then it became a doctor's office, and as I understand it, several other things in between.
Oh, a lot of things in between. Sam Waugh's, the laundry went down, it became a doctor's office, it became, I believe it was even a temporary mortuary at some time, and then it was moved around several times because they could not find a legitimate location for it. But it has transformed itself, and now in the 21st century, it occupies a stately position in Bancroft Park, as it should have, because the history of Colorado City, the history of Colorado, began within these walls.
Here's the Old Colorado City History Center, operated by the Old Colorado City Historical Society. It's an old church built in the late 1800s, and the Historical Society took it over 20 years ago or so, and they're the ones that maintain it and have lots of programs about the area. So here we are inside what was originally built in 1890 as the First Baptist Church of Colorado City. Since 1995, it's been the museum operated by the Old Colorado City Historical Society. Here in the History Center, it's just chock full of historical documents and items from back in the day, since 1859, when Colorado City was founded as the jumping off place for miners and prospectors on their way to the gold fields up in Cripple Creek.
My name is Leo Knudsen. I've been a member of the Old Colorado City Historical Society for numerous years. I'm a volunteer here, and I'm in charge of maintenance of this building. The history of the building itself goes back to 1889, when 16 members of the Baptist Church met at the Women's Christian Temperance Union Hall for their services, and they were charging them $1.50 a week, and they said that was entirely too much money. So one of the members, a woman named Jane Quimby, had some property here in town, and she offered three different sites for the new church. The group then picked this site here on 24th and Pikes Peak as their new church. They hired a fellow architect named Walter Fairquhar Douglas, who was a noted architect here at this time. They hired a local builder, and they built this building in 1890. Their first service was in February of 1890. The minister at that time was F.W. Hart, and they had a small membership at the time, but the church was built to house 200 members. The church at that time did not offer any quarters for the minister nor his family. So about 1915, they rebuilt the basement for a fellowship hall and a Sunday school, and they put a bathroom and a kitchen down there at that time. This was the First Baptist Church up to 1917, when Colorado Springs annexed Colorado City. We could no longer be the First Baptist Church because First Baptist Church was downtown Colorado Springs. So we became the Bethel Baptist Church, and it's remained as a Bethel Baptist Church till they built their new church downtown also. In 1942, the Immanuel Missionary College bought this building. We were looking for a museum, the society was. In doing so, they found one across town, but this building came up available through donations and a grant. We obtained this building and we put it together the way it is today. I'll speak to you a little bit about Laura Bell McDaniels. She originally came from Missouri, and she set up the nicest parlor house we had in town. We had 8 brothels on what was called Washington Avenue at that time, but is now Jacarus. Her parlor house was on the corner of 26th and Jacarus, and it was a very elaborate. And at that time, you have to realize that there was different stages. The men who had money went to the parlor houses. Those in the blue-collar workers usually went to bordellos or brothels. Those that had less money went to the cribs and the dives. And Laura Bell's was a number one place. It was very exclusive, cost a lot of money. The girls would get anywhere from $25 to $50. Sometimes a night would cost you $250. They dressed elaborate. This dress is symbol more of what the saloon girls would wear, because Laura Bell's girls dressed differently. Everything's cataloged, and we're in the process of putting everything on a computer now. But all these drawers back in here have, we have pictures here. But these are all artifacts through the years. People donate them. And then when we do displays upstairs, we can take a lot of these items upstairs for displays. It's just original bell from the church when it was built in the 1890s. A lot of our guests coming in, especially the kids, love to ring the bell.
And as you can see, that side of the street is sunny, and this side is shady. Well, it's shady for more than one reason. This side of the street used to be where all the saloons and brothels were. And right here, one of them is still here, and Thunder and Buttons. Let's go inside and I'll tell you an interesting story about the name of Thunder and Buttons. So here we are at Thunder and Buttons, named after 2 domesticated elk that pulled a wagon from downtown out here to Colorado City. The building was built around 1915. It's been lots of different things. It was originally a restaurant, and the elk were owned by Prairie Dog O'Byrne. was sort of a character, as you might imagine. One of the interesting tales about Thunder and Buttons was that the elk pulled the wagon, which was sort of the personal transportation for Laura Bell, who's one of the notorious madams of the era. Right here is an old carriage that may have been pulled by the elk, by one of the elk, to bring Laura Bell from downtown Colorado Springs out here to Colorado City.
Hi, I'm Heather. I own Thunder and Buttons Bar and Grill. We're in old Colorado City. We've been here about 7 years. It was built in the early 1900s. There were bars and brothels up and down Colorado Avenue, and I believe we were on the brothel side. Thunder and Buttons were a couple of elk that were domesticated by Prairie Dog O'Byrne, who was kind of a local character. He domesticated the elk when they were young and had them pull his carriage up and down Colorado Avenue. He had a prairie dog on the back of his carriage. That's why they call him Prairie Dog O'Byrne. And he's claimed that they could recognize him on sight. Thunder and Buttons is in Old Colorado City, which is a great part of Colorado Springs. It's the historic district, has a lot of great shops, a lot of great restaurants. Of course, we're the best restaurant. We cook everything fresh. We have a chef that makes everything fresh every day. We grind our own sausage. We make everything fresh to order, all of our sauces, all of our meals to order, and you can have a great variety. We have kind of upscale bar food is what we call it, so you can get anything from nachos to fresh salmon any day. I love this area town. I wouldn't live anywhere else in town, and it's nice to know that I can walk places. People down here are great. They're so different and diverse, and everyone's really nice and open. It's kind of like a small town, just in this little part of the city, which always makes you feel welcome. You always see people you know. You can just walk to the post office. You can walk to shops. You can walk to restaurants, coffee shops. It's just a great place to be.
Wow. Today, Thunder and Buttons is known for its great food, their elk chili and their bison burger are two of the favorites. And here we are at the Carnegie Library, built in 1904, thanks to Andrew Carnegie, the philanthropist who built these libraries all over the country. Well, it's been upgraded and updated since then, and has all the modern things that you would expect in a library, but it still retains the old feel. Let's go ahead and take a look. So here we are in the original Carnegie Library, built in 1904, and still operating today. So not only is this building full of books, it's full of history.
Hi, my name is David Rasmussen. I'm an information specialist here at the 1904 Carnegie Library, officially known as the Old Colorado City Community Library of the Pikes Peak Library District. This actual building was constructed in 1904 with monies that were donated by Andrew Carnegie, who of course is famous for Carnegie Libraries across the United States. Over thousands of libraries were built with his money, but the catch that he always had was that the communities had to provide the staffing and the books and the monies to keep the libraries open and running. So it was a good partnership between the communities and Carnegie to provide the facility. This library actually, though, had a couple predecessors because public libraries were just coming into their own back there in the early 1900s. There was a small library that was started over in on the main road, on the main Colorado Avenue over there in the late 1890s. And that was started by Women's Christian Temperance Union because it was a pretty wild neighborhood and they thought it was a good place to have for people who needed an alternative activity to drinking. And that developed into, originally it was a paid per membership library, but it developed into a free public library, the Linda Woods Free Library. Moved to another temporary position, but then that was in a right position to move into this building when it opened in 1904. A library in a community represents a lot more than just physical items on a shelf. It really represents what a community strives to be and sort of an encapsulation of its entire past and all that it's accomplished over the years. It would be very interesting if somebody from, say, 1904, 1905, when this first opened, they thought it was so state-of-the-art and up-to-date. It would be interesting if somebody came in today to know what they'd think. But I tend to think Carnegie, he was a very progressive man, had a lot of great forward-looking ideas, great with technology and the serving the future. I think while a lot of those people would be surprised at what they saw today, I think they would quickly warm to it and realize that that's what libraries, and especially Old Colorado City, is all about, is moving forward and mankind progressing. So a lot of the things that we offer today that they would not have been familiar with, of course, is computers, and we offer all kinds of computers. Not only do we have the computers that patrons can use, we have laptops that they can check out, we have free Wi-Fi so they can bring in their own computers and do anything they want. And then for many years now, libraries have offered downloadable items, so people don't even really have to come into the physical library to take advantage of the wonderful resources that it makes available. People from the past would find that surprising, but I think they'd learn to like it really, really fast. Yeah, so here we have some pictures from the past. This first one here would have been from the newspaper of the time, 1904, when it opened. It shows how slick and it looked in those first opening days. And then just to the left of that is a picture of the interior, sometime later, but it still would have been how it looked when it was opened. And that's our famous, not very first, but one of the early librarians, Helen Ellenswood. She's here for quite some time, and she had quite an interesting reputation herself, as did her husband in the area. So if people want to come in here and experience not only a little bit of the past, but also everything that's available right now, we're located in Old Colorado City on the west side. It's 2418 West Pikes Peak Avenue. The zip code 80904. If you want to give us a call, our phone number is 719-634-1698.
Thanks for joining us in Old Colorado City. If you want more information, you can look us up online, and we'll see you next time.